So we're going to be working from the threaded end. So this is going to be our fixed reference point. We're going to measure from here, and hopefully when we've finished and we measure it after we put the bend in, that's where we'll measure from. So we want the distance from the end of this threaded end to the back of the conduit bend to be 300 millimeters exactly.
Is that going to be the first measurement that you make, the 300
mil? Exactly. So yep, so I'm going to measure 300 mil from the threaded end down to here. So just get 300 mil on there, which is just there. So that's my 300 millimeter mark. Nicely done. So what I want is I want my conduit, once it's been bent, I want the back of this piece of tube here to be level with that mark there at 300 mil going down there. So now what I've got to do is put it into the conduit bending machine in the right way. So if I just, I won't use the handle for the time being, just to illustrate the point of what I'm trying to do. So I've got my stop up and in the right position. I've got my conduit in the former and that's ready to go. And now what I've got to do is try and figure out where the back of this bend will be after I've bent it. So what I need to do here is use a scrap piece of conduit. And if I plunk this into the former like that, you can see that that represents what the end of the conduit will look like once it's been bent, after the bending's been taken place. So what I need to do is line up this mark that I made at 300 mil with where the back edge of this piece of tube will be. So I'm gonna line it up just about there. Now, the only other critical thing that I have to do here is think about the angle that I'm bending it to. Because I'm bending this to 90 degrees, I've got to make sure that this all lines up when the piece of tube that I've put in is at 90 degrees. So let's just have a little look at that. So I'm gonna put my combi square in here and make sure that that is nice and square. So I'll get that lined up there. Now you can see that that is square. So the two pieces of conduit are at a right angle to each other. But now what I need to do is just make sure that my mark that I've put on is in the right place. And it is. So it's lined up with the back of this piece of conduit when this piece of conduit is at 90 degrees to this one. And that's going to give me the correct position for the bend.
Okay, Joe. So if we change the position now of the camera so we can see this a little bit closer in,
yep.
You can just repeat that process as you go through to put your 90 degree bend in. So we've got the arm of the conduit bending machine now upright. Can you just position it as you described previously for me?
Yep. So in bringing the arm up, obviously the conduit's shifted a little bit. So what I'm going to do is just push that in until that mark that I made earlier now lines up with the back edge of the conduit when, and this is critical, this piece of conduit is at 90 degrees to this piece. I want that mark to line up with the back of this piece of conduit because this piece of conduit represents where the bend will go after I've pulled the handle down. So that looks pretty good to me. I'd say that's in the right position now and that's ready to bend. Now this is the tricky part. If you can get this to 90 degrees on the first go, then you've done really well. I always underestimate it, so mine's always not quite 90 degrees, so I'm going to just go over just a little bit on this one. So I reckon that must be somewhere about close. So I'm going to take this out and I'm going to show you the best way of checking that this is 90 now. So what I'm going to do, I like to use another piece of tube as a reference point. It's always useful to have a scrap piece of tube when you're bending conduit. And then I've offered this up against here, just hold it tight there. So that is now parallel to that piece. And by offering up my combi square, you can see there that I'm not quite at 90 because there is no gap at this end and quite a large gap down here where this remains straight. You can see we need to put a little bit more in that. So I'm just going to go back over to the bender, put a little bit more bend in there, and then we'll have a look at whether I've got it to 90 or not. Generally speaking, it's best to underbend it a little bit because it's easier to put more bend in than it is to get bend out. So I'm actually quite happy with that as a result. I'll just tweak it a little bit. It's actually quite an irritating amount to get in that I need to do. But what I'm going to do is I'm just going to lift the arm up on the bending machine here and just illustrate the point that this should really go back into the bender in the same way that it came out. So this is the end that we measured from and we had this sticking out over here before. So I'm going to stick it back in the same way like that. And then I just need to put a little bit more bend in. Now this will surprise you how much more bend will go in without too much effort. Generally speaking, it just wants to be the weight of your arm that takes this down a little bit. If we overdo this, it's possible but challenging to get the bend out. So let's just have a little look at that. We'll just put a little bit more and you can actually feel it go. You can feel it give when it does bend. Sometimes you think, oh, that's bent and it's not moved, because what's happened is that the whole rig's just tightened up and got to the position where it's going to start bending. So you can actually feel it start to bend when it goes. So we'll take that out and see if we've got that to 90 now.
I love that phrase, Joe, the weight of your arm. It's one I shout out in the workshop. You just got to feel it go, just the weight of your arm if you're just feathering it in. Okay, let's check that again.
Yep, we've got it to exactly 90 off camera. I think we'll do a future video on mackling conduit when it's not gone quite right first time. We'll show you how to do bits and bobs like that. But if we just look here now, you can see that that is nice and close to 90 degrees there. We've got that at, so that bend is now at 90. And now, really, the aim of this whole video was to try and prove that you can put a bend into a piece of tube at exactly the right length without having to trim it off afterwards. So hopefully, this line here, the front of this piece of tube, represents the back of the bend, because we've just kicked that off parallel. And what we'll do is, if we measure from there to there, we should have that magical number of 300 mil. So let's see if I've managed to bend this accurately enough. Look at that, 300 mil on the nose. Absolutely beautiful. So again, we've bent that really millimeter accurate without having to trim anything off afterwards.